ट्रेड पेबल टर्नओवर रेशियो, इट इज ऑल्सो कम्स अंडर एक्टिविटी रेशियो एंड द पर्पज ऑफ एक्टिविटी रेशियो इज टू चेक ऑपरेशनल एफिशियंसी ऑफ द बिजनेस, है ना. मोर द रेशियो बेटर द कंडीशन, रिमेंबर मोर द रेशियो बेटर द कंडीशन. इट इज फोर टाइम्स इट इज बेटर, इफ इट इज फाइव टाइम इट इज मोर बेटर, इफ इट इज सिक्स टाइम इट इज मोर बेटर, लाइक दैट, है ना. ट्रेड पेबल, वॉट डू यू मीन बाई ट्रेड पेबल? ट्रेड पेबल मीन्स क्रेडिटर्स एंड बिल्स पेबल. सो द फॉर्मूला ऑफ ट्रेड पेबल टर्न ओवर रेशियो इज नेट क्रेडिट परचेज अपॉन एवरेज ट्रेड पेबल, एवरेज ट्रेड पेबल्स. वॉट इज क्रेडिट परचेज? टोटल परचेज माइनस कैश परचेज इज इक्वल टू क्रेडिट परचेज, है ना. एंड एवरेज ट्रेड पेबल, इट इज द सेम थिंग. एवरेज ट्रेड पेबल, लाइक वी हैव लर्न इन एवरेज ट्रेड रिसीवेबल्स, average trade payable is equal to opening trade payable plus closing trade payable divide by 2, hai na. So this is what the formula of trade payable turnover ratio. And trade payable means, once again I will tell you, trade payable includes creditors and bills payable. Okay, so this is what the information which we have, and we need to solve some numericals of trade payable turnover ratio. So let's begin with question number 100. Calculate trade payable turnover ratio and average debt payment period from the following information. So trade payable turnover ratio, question number 100. Trade payable turnover ratio means net credit purchase upon average trade payable. So in the question, what is given? Creditors are given and bills payable are given. Opening and closing both are given. Total purchase is given. Purchase return is given, cash purchase is given. So we can easily calculate. First we will calculate net credit purchase, hai na. So net credit purchase means total purchase minus purchase return minus cash purchase, है ना. सो टोटल परचेज इज गिवन इन द क्वेश्चन 21 लाख माइनस परचेज रिटर्न, इट इज गिवन 1 लाख, एंड माइनस कैश परचेज, कैश परचेज इज गिवन 4 लाख. सो 21 माइनस 120 एंड 20 माइनस 4, 16 लाख इज नेट क्रेडिट परचेज. इज दैट क्लियर? वेरी सिंपल. Now we need to calculate average trade payable. Average trade payables means opening plus closing divide by 2. So opening trade payable are given 1,50,000 and 50,000. This is opening 1,50,000 plus 50,000. This is opening trade payable plus closing trade payable 4,50,000 and 1,50,000. 4,50,000 and 1,50,000. So opening trade payable plus closing trade payable divide by 2, we get average trade payable. So average trade payable will be 150 plus 50, 2 lakh. 450 plus 150, 6 lakh. 6 plus 2, 8 lakh. 8 lakh divide by 2, 4 lakh. So this is your average trade payable. Okay. What to calculate? We need to calculate trade payable turnover ratio. So net credit purchase we have computed 16 lakh. And average trade payable we have computed 4 lakh. When we divide, what we get? 4 times. What do you mean 4 times? Trade payable turnover ratio is 4 times. What does it mean? It means that in 1 year, we pay to the creditors 4 times. This is what the capacity of the business. Hai na? If we are paying 5 times, 6 times, then if it is more, then capacity is more. In this question, one more thing we need to calculate now. Average debt payment. So, in how many months we are paying the debt? Hai na? So, let's calculate average debt payment period. Debt payment period, average debt payment period, how to calculate? See, trade payable turnover ratio is given, how much? 4 times, isn't it? When it is given, now we can guess, in 1 year, how many months are there? 12 months. How many months? 12 months. So divide by trade payable turnover ratio. If you want to calculate in days, then you can divide it by 360, you will get answer in days. So 12 month divide by 4 times. 4 times, it will be 3 month. This is average debt payment period. This is what the capacity of business to purchase goods and then repay money within 3 months. So this is what the conditions. I hope this question is clear to you. Question number 101. Calculate trade payables turnover ratio from the following information. Okay. Opening creditor is given 125,000. Opening creditors 125,000. Opening bills payable 10,000. Opening bills payable is given 10,000. Closing creditors 90,000. Closing creditor is given 90,000. Closing bills payable 5,000. Closing bills payable is given, once again let me check, 5,000. Okay. And what else is given? Purchases is given 950,000. Purchase is given 950,000. Cash purchase is given 1 lakh. Cash purchase is given 1 lakh. And purchase return is given 45,000. Purchase return is given 45,000. We need to calculate trade payable turnover ratio. Okay. So, how to calculate trade payable turnover ratio? Trade payable turnover ratio means net credit purchase upon average trade payable. It is very easy to calculate. Net credit purchase we can calculate by subtracting purchase return and cash purchase from purchase. So we can calculate here only 950 minus 1 lakh, 8 lakh 50, 8 lakh 50 minus 45, 8 lakh 5,000. Hai na? Correct? Yes. And we need to calculate average trade payable. So, average trade payable we can easily calculate. How to calculate opening trade payable? 1 lakh 25,000 plus 10,000. Opening trade payable plus closing trade payables 90 plus 90,000 plus 5,000 divide by 2. So let me divide, dear children, just a minute. Yes, 125,000, 135,000 plus 95,000 इक्वल टू 2,30,000 डिवाइड बाय 2, 1,15,000. सो 1,15,000 इज एवरेज ट्रेड पेबल एंड 8,05,000 इज अवर नेट क्रेडिट परचेज. सो वी कैन पुट दीज वैल्यूज इन द फॉर्मूला, 8,05,000 डिवाइड बाय 1,15,000. वॉट वी गेट, लेट मी डिवाइड. 8,05,000 डिवाइड बाय 1,15,000 इज इक्वल टू 7 times. ओके, सो आई होप दिस इज क्लियर टू एवरीवन. यस डियर चिल्ड्रन, सो लेट्स मूव ऑन नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन नंबर 102. Okay, very good question it is. Many points are given here. Calculate trade payable turnover ratio for the year 2021 in each of the alternative cases. Case 1, closing trade payable is given 45,000. Net purchase is given. Purchase return is given. And cash purchase is given. Okay, hai na? Case 1, see what is given. Closing trade payable 45,000. Closing trade payable 45,000. Then net purchase is given 3,60,000. Net purchase is given 3,65,000. Hai na? 3,60,000. 3,60,000. Okay. Then purchase return is given 60,000 and cash purchase is given 90,000. Okay. So purchase return is given 60,000 and cash purchase 90,000. Okay dear children, so what to calculate? We need to calculate trade payable turnover ratio and our formula is net credit purchase upon average trade payable. Children, let me ask one question from all of you. Anyone can tell me that how to calculate average trade payable here? क्लोजिंग ट्रेड पेबल इज गिवन, ओपनिंग इज नॉट गिवन, तो कैसे कैलकुलेट करेंगे? नहीं करेंगे ना. क्लोजिंग ट्रेड पेबल
क्लोजिंग ट्रेड पेबल्स ओनली.
हाँ, क्लोजिंग ट्रेड पेबल इज कंसीडर्ड एज एवरेज ट्रेड पेबल. वेरी गुड. इन मॉर्निंग आई थिंक आई हैव एक्सप्लेन दिस पॉइंट, है ना. नाउ वी नीड टू कैलकुलेट नेट क्रेडिट परचेज, डियर चिल्ड्रन. सो डियर चिल्ड्रन, सी दिस इज वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चन आई एम टेलिंग यू. Net purchase is given. What is the meaning of net purchase? The meaning of net purchase means in which purchase return is already deducted. Do you understand? Children, purchase return is already deducted, that is known as net purchase. And we need net credit purchase. So purchase return is already deducted in net purchase. So that's why we will calculate in this manner. 3,60,000 minus 90,000, only cash purchase we deduct. Purchase return we do not deduct because already net purchase is given. So when we subtract now, 360 minus 90, what we get? 2,70,000. Yes or no? Hai na? So net credit purchase is 2,70,000 divided by average trade payable 45,000. Let me divide it. 2,70,000 divided by 45,000 is equal to 6 times. Yes or no, dear children? Do you understand this question, this case?
Yes,
very. This is very. These small things are very helpful. लेट सी वन मोर केस, है ना, केस इन केस टू इट इज गिवन ओपनिंग ट्रेड पेबल 15,000 एंड क्लोजिंग ट्रेड पेबल 45 एंड नेट परचेज इज गिवन. नाउ इन दिस क्वेश्चन क्रेडिट परचेज हाउ डू कैलकुलेट, दिस इज व्हाट द प्रॉब्लम, है ना. केस टू बिकॉज नेट परचेज इज गिवन हाउ मच 360,000 एंड ओपनिंग एंड क्लोजिंग ट्रेड पेबल्स आर गिवन. सो वी कैन कैलकुलेट एवरेज ट्रेड पेबल्स, ओपनिंग प्लस क्लोजिंग डिवाइड बाय 2, 15 प्लस 45 डिवाइड बाय 2. सो 15,000 प्लस 45,000 डिवाइड बाय 2, 60 डिवाइड बाय 2, 30,000. नाउ ओनली नेट परचेज इज गिवन, हाउ टू कैलकुलेट क्रेडिट परचेज, देर इज नो इन्फॉर्मेशन गिवन इन द क्वेश्चन, इजंट इट. सो दिस नेट परचेज विल बी कंसिडर्ड एज नेट क्रेडिट परचेज. Is that clear? So trade payable turnover ratio, net credit purchase upon average trade payable. So this net purchase will be considered as net credit purchase because in question no information is given to calculate net credit purchase, hai na? So 360,000 divided by 30,000, and when we divide, what we get? 12 times. Yes or no? I hope this point is clear to everyone. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Yes. Let's come on one more point. Case 3. Case number 3. In case 3, closing trade payable is given 45 and net purchase is given. Now what we will do? See, only closing trade payable is given 45,000. Okay, so we will not calculate average trade payable because opening is not given, so this will be considered as average trade payable. Then net purchase is given 360,000. Only net purchase is given 360,000. Now what we will do? No other information is given, so we will consider it as a net credit purchase. Okay, so trade payable turnover ratio we will solve in this manner. Net credit purchase 360,000, we will consider this net purchase as net credit purchase and closing trade payable as average trade payable because opening trade payable is not given. So 45,000. Okay, so when we divide, when we divide, what we get? 360 divided by 40, 8 times. I hope this case is also clear. Let's yes, move sir. On another point, case 4. Closing trade payable including 25,000 due to a supplier of machinery. Supplier of machinery. Is machine a good? Is machinery comes under goods? Tell me.
No, sir, it is an asset.
It is an asset.
No, sir.
Very good. So, in closing trade payables, including 25,000 due to a supplier of machinery, so we need to deduct it. Yes or no? Hai na? So, 55 minus 25, closing trade payable will be 55,000 minus 25,000 because it is due to a supplier of machinery, not of goods. So what we get? 30,000. Okay, this is closing trade payable and net credit purchase is given 360,000. So it is very simple. Trade payable turnover ratio, net credit purchase is given 360,000 divided by average trade payable, but only closing trade payable is given, opening trade payable is not given. So we divide it by 30,000. What we get? 12 times. Hai na? I hope it is clear. All these questions, all these cases are clear to everyone.
Yes, sir.
Hai na? Question number 103. वन मिनट यस यस क्वेश्चन नंबर 103 एट द एंड है ना. क्लोजिंग ट्रेड पेबल इज गिवन 5,40,000 103 क्लोजिंग ट्रेड पेबल इज गिवन 5,40,000 नेट परचेज इज गिवन 4,320 नाउ अगेन नेट परचेज इज गिवन मीन्स इन विच परचेज रिटर्न इज डिडक्टेड बट इन दिस क्वेश्चन इट इज नॉट गिवन. कैश परचेज इज गिवन 10,80,000 ओके सो नेट परचेज इज गिवन 43,20,000 एंड वी सब्ट्रैक्ट कैश परचेज बिकॉज वी नीड क्रेडिट परचेज. कैश परचेज इज गिवन 10,80,000 10,80,000 यस और नो. सो लेट मी सब्ट्रैक्ट 43,20,000 माइनस 10,80,000 सो वॉट वी गेट 32,40,000 32,40,000 ओके एंड क्लोजिंग ट्रेड पेबल इज गिवन 5,40,000 ओपनिंग ट्रेड पेबल इज नॉट गिवन डियर चिल्ड्रन सो वॉट वी विल डू वी विल कंसिडर इट एज एन एवरेज ट्रेड पेबल है ना. सो ट्रेड पेबल टर्नओवर रेशियो इज इक्वल टू नेट क्रेडिट परचेज अपॉन एवरेज ट्रेड पेबल है ना. नेट क्रेडिट परचेज इज 32,40,000 वी हैव कंप्यूटेड एंड क्लोजिंग ट्रेड पेबल विल बी कंसिडर्ड एज एवरेज ट्रेड पेबल दैट इज 5,40,000 सो लेट मी डिवाइड 32,40,000 divide by once again 32,40,000 divide by 5,40,000 six times okay. I hope it is clear to everyone. Trade payable turnover ratio and trade receivable turnover ratio, there is nothing much difference in calculation. Everything is similar. Only there we were using trade receivables, here we are using trade payables. Hai na? Only figures are different, or rest of the things are similar. Hai? So let's solve one more question. 104, question number 104. Calculation of opening and closing trade payables. Question number 104. From the following information, calculate opening and closing trade payables. Cash purchase is 25% of total purchase. Okay, we write this information. Given cash purchase is 25% of total purchase. Fine. Revenue from operation means sales is given. Net sales is given 3 lakh. Revenue from operation is given 3 lakh. Gross profit is 25% on RFO. Gross profit is given 25%. Okay. And opening inventory 75,000. Closing inventory 1,50,000. Opening inventory is given 75,000 है ना. यस एंड क्लोजिंग इन्वेंट्री इज गिवन 1,50,000 एंड क्लोजिंग इन्वेंट्री इज गिवन 1,50,000. ट्रेड पेबल टर्नओवर रेशियो 3 टाइम्स वेरी गुड. ट्रेड पेबल टर्नओवर रेशियो इज गिवन 3 टाइम्स एंड व्हाट इज गिवन. Closing trade payables were 75,000 in excess of opening trade payables. Okay. So it means we assume that opening trade payable is X. So closing trade payable will be closing trade payable were 75,000 in excess. Means X plus 75,000. So these are the information which are given to us. And what to calculate? calculate opening and closing trade payable? Very good question, children. Please put tick mark. Very good question. है ना? हाँ. So, how do we calculate and what do we calculate first? To calculate it first, children, see, we have formula of trade payable turnover ratio. Yes or no? है ना? So first we write formula. This is the best way to solve always. Trade payable turnover ratio formula is net credit purchase upon average trade payable. So we need to calculate average trade payable first. To calculate average trade payable, we need net credit purchase. Yes or no? है ना? Isn't it? And trade payable turnover ratio is given 3 times. These two values are not given. Now tell me, from where do we calculate credit purchase from these given information? Can anybody identify from where do we calculate?
Sir, we can calculate COGS.
Okay, we can calculate COGS. Very good. Then what we do with the COGS?
Sir, COGS equal to opening stock plus purchases minus closing stock.
बहुत बढ़िया. So then we can... बहुत बढ़िया. बहुत बढ़िया. Very good. Very good. So this is what I am saying na. Maybe in examination some questions comes when something do not click immediately na. So this is very right way to write the formulas whatever is given. So here it is given revenue from operation and gross profit is given. So we can calculate COGS from by here. Very good. Very good. So as we know that COGS, cost of goods sold, is equal to revenue from operation minus gross profit. Hai na? So we can calculate first COGS here. RFO is given 3 lakh in this question. Minus gross profit is 25%. 25% of 3 lakh is 75,000. Yes or no? So 3 lakh minus 75,000. 2,25,000. This is your cost of goods sold. Huh? Yes or no? And,
yes, sir.
And the formula of cost of goods sold, cost of goods sold is opening inventory plus purchases minus closing stock. Yes or no? So we need to reach up to this credit purchase. So we can reach here. Cost of goods sold is 2,25,000. We have computed here. Is equal to opening inventory. Is it given? Yes, it is given 75,000. Purchase is given? No, we need to calculate purchase. Closing inventory is given? Yes, it is given. How much? 1,50,000 it is given. 1,50,000. 2,25,000 minus plus 1,50,000. Isn't it? Is equal to 75,000 plus purchase. Sahi hai? Clear hai? And then
yes, sir.
And then 2,25,000 plus 150, इसको यहीं सॉल्व कर लेते हैं, है ना, स्टेप बाय स्टेप. सो 2,25,000, जस्ट अ मिनट, 2,25,000 प्लस 1,50,000 इज इक्वल टू 3,75,000. 3,75,000 इज इक्वल टू 75,000 प्लस परचेस. एंड देन अगेन वी चेंज द साइड, देन 75,000 विल कम हियर. So it will be 3,75,000 minus 75,000 is equal to purchase. Yes or no? And then your purchase will be 3 lakh rupees. By using this formula, we have computed purchase. But in the question, what is required? We need net credit purchase. Can we calculate net credit purchase with the given information?
Yes, sir.
Yes. What is given in the first line, you can see cash purchase is 25% of total purchase. If cash purchase is 25% of total purchase, what will be credit purchase? 75%. Yes or no? Hai na?
Yes, sir.
So credit.
Yes, sir.
Credit purchase will be 75% of 3 lakh. So 3 lakh multiply by 75%. So 3 lakh into 75%, 225,000. So now your credit purchase is 225,000. We can put credit purchase here in this formula. Hai na? Trade payable turnover ratio is given. Net credit purchase we have computed. So now we can put in the formula trade payable turnover ratio, net credit purchase upon average trade payable. Hai na? Trade payable turnover ratio is given how much? Let's see. It is given three times. Net credit purchase 225,000 upon average trade payable. Now we can calculate average trade payable. So average trade payable is equal to 225,000 divided by 3. What we get, children? 75,000, yes or no?
75,000.
Now we have formula of average trade payable. Average trade payable formula is opening trade payable plus closing trade payable divided by 2. Average trade payable we have computed 75,000. Opening trade payable is not given, but we have written something according to given question x and x plus 75,000. Hai na? So x opening trade payable, then x plus 75,000 closing trade payable divided by 2. Okay, so let's cross multiply. 75 2 ja 150,000 is equal to 2x plus 75,000. So 75 will come here, so it will be 2x is equal to 75,000. I hope it is clear.
Yes, sir.
X is equal to 75,000 by 2, that will be 37,500. Am I correct? This is your opening trade payable, and closing trade payable is 70. How much? Closing trade payable is 75,000 more, hai na? According to the question, 75,000, yes. So closing trade payable is equal to 37,500 plus 75,000. Let us add these two. 37,500 plus 75,000. 1,12,500. I hope the question is clear to everyone.
Sir.
Yes, dear children.